Have you ever wondered, how do you make a crystal? Today, we're learning about all of that and more with my experiment, Crystal Names. Hi everyone, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we learn about all things space and science. So grab your pipe cleaners because we're about to crystallize. Crystals are highly organized solids with a regular repeating structure of molecules, and we are going to make some today. What you need for this one is 2 cups of hot water, 6 tablespoons of borax, a tall heat-resistant glass, some pipe cleaners, some tape, some popsicle sticks, and some string and some scissors. So what you want to do is boil 2 cups of water on the stove. And after you've done that, take it off the heat, and we're going to add 6 tablespoons of borax. Stir in between each one. You want your borax to completely dissolve in your solution. And you'll know when it's dissolved when you don't see any white powder left. 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now stir it in until all of the borax dissolves. You want your solution to be clear. And if you're having a hard time getting this to dissolve, just put it back on the stovetop and heat it up a little bit more, because hot solution will hold more borax than cold solution, and so that will allow it to dissolve more easily. Now what you want to do is pour your borax solution into your heat-resistant glass. And you want to be very careful here not to get any of the additional borax into your glass. So just make sure that you don't see any borax crystals on the bottom of your glass. And if you do, that's okay. Just get another glass and carefully pour that glass into another one, and just keep doing that until you prevent any of those crystals from being in your glass. So what you've created is a fully saturated borax solution. You have dissolved as much borax as humanly possible into your water. And as this cools, cold solution can't hold as much borax as hot solution. So all of a sudden, a lot of that borax is trying to jump out of the solution. It's trying to undissolve, and it undissolves as highly organized crystals. They become just so beautiful. So we're just going to give those crystals something to hold on to, and that's where our pipe cleaners come in. So what we're going to do is make initials for your name out of our pipe cleaners. I'm going to make E for Emily. Now we are going to suspend our letter in our borax solution. So you need to get your string, and we're going to tie it right at the top. Now we're going to tape this to our popsicle stick. You can tell how long we need it based off of how high your water is in your glass. We just want to fully submerge our letter. So we just want this to be maybe about this tall on our popsicle stick. I'm going to wrap my string around it and then use the tape to tape it on. So now that we have our letter, let's go ahead and submerge it in our borax solution. And be very careful not to let your letter touch the sides, because that'll connect the crystals from the letter to the sides. And we just want all the crystals to form on our little letter here. This works really well because if you look at pipe cleaners, they have all of these tiny little fibers. That gives those crystals something to cling on to, something to build off of. So this works really, really well for crystal growth. And now we are going to let our solution cool overnight. And as it cools, all of that extra borax is going to grab onto the pipe cleaner and create our crystal name. Now that you have this submerged, you just need to wait a couple of hours for your solution to cool to start seeing those crystals. And for larger crystals, just let it sit overnight, and even bigger crystals will grow. And if you wait overnight, your crystals will look like this. Look how pretty those are. Borax crystals are elite. They're so beautiful. It's incredible how big they get. But for parents and adults, just a note of safety, you do not want to eat these. These are not safe to eat. So make sure you keep these away from pets and babies. These would actually make really good ornaments if you wanted to use these for Christmas time. You can design different structures. You could make a tree. You can make a heart. You can make a snowman, star, planet. You can make a Saturn, a snowflake.
we've got more work to do.
If you want to store these for months or even years, I recommend just putting them in a Tupperware bin. These crystals are pretty resilient, they're pretty sturdy, but if you do rub on them, they will come off. So you just don't want to, you know, you don't want to like play with them because they will break off, right? Thanks for making crystal names with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring books for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.